Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 33 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 62 questions in previous video, and today we are going to look into question number 63. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant named adatom.com. Adatom.com contains the groups in following table. So we do have multiple groups for adatom.com. The group 1 is a security group. Okay. And member type is dynamic user can join. So let's first understand what is the group type. Means what does it mean that we have security group? So basically security group is used to manage user and computer access to shared resources. For example, we can create a security group so that all the group members have same set of security permissions. Members of security group can include users, devices or other groups, and service principals, which define the access policy and permissions. So that's what the security group is. Let's see, the next one is membership type. So what's the dynamic user membership type? So here dynamic user means this group, if someone is the member of this group, have certain rules in place. So let's say we can have member attributes, let's say is city or maybe is a department or something else. From the attribute we can define a rule for that attribute, and once that rule meet the requirement, that member automatically be added to this group, and based on that change on the profile, it can, you know, automatically be removed from this group. So these are called dynamic user groups. So member type is dynamic user, and membership rule. So here rule is defined. If you can see the user dot city, so whoever belong to that particular city which name is starting with M letter, that will automatically be member of the group 1. So that is the rule. Now same way the group 2 is again group type is Microsoft Office 365, which means this is different group type, and it provides the collaboration opportunity by giving the group member access to shared mailbox, calendar, files and SharePoint sites. So these are, you know, a little bit different in defining. Again, the dynamic user, we know that it can automatically. So logic here is the or rule for this one is user dot department. So whoever belong not to this department, not in human resource, can be the member of this group. And group 3 is again Microsoft Office 365 group type, and it is assigned. So membership type is different here. That earlier one was dynamic, so based on the profile it was, but assigned is like manually we can add someone to this group or remove to this group. I hope about the group it is clear to you that we do have two membership type and two type of groups here. Let's see next. You create two users account that are configured as shown in following table. So we do have two user accounts, user 1 and user 2. User 1 lives in Montreal and he is working for human resources and having Office 365 license as well. Same way user 2 lives in Melbourne and works for marketing department and no Office 365 license associated with this. So which group do you, user 1 and user 2 belong? So we just need to have you know, understanding that by these definitions of user, which group they are falling in. So let's see. So for user 1, we can easily see that he can be associated with group 1 because he lives in city in the name starting with M. The same way user 2 also can be associated with the group 1. So that also starting with the letter M. So both are in group one. Both are group one's member. Next one, let's see group two. So department not in HR. So one of them, the user two, is not having department HR. So he can be member of group two. But at the same time, user one is member of HR. Therefore, he will not be the member of this group. And for the group three, we can see that it can manually be applied. So there is no certain condition which is giving them the permission in this group, and it should manually be applied. So as per the question, user one and user two, by this given scenario, are belong to group one and group two only. So let's see in the answer area. So we'll select group one answer for user one, and for user two, group one and group two. I hope this video was informative for you, and please like, subscribe and press the bell notification icon. Also share with your friends. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.